Hey everyone, welcome to another series of Getting to Know Your Center Owners. I'm with Karen today from Garland, Texas, and she is amazing. I get so many rave reviews about her from her clients. So I'm not going to be the star of this show. I'm going to turn it over to Karen. She's going to tell you who she is and how the egg found her.
Thank you, Gail. Appreciate that. So I'm Karen Kunzman, and I own the egg in Garland, Texas. My center is called Harmonic Life. And I found the egg in a way that a number of people have found the egg, but I was trying to address my own health challenges. And I found the interview on reginameredith.com. And it was interesting because I'd looked at that site a number of times over the past, say, month, and I never saw this interview. And I had been meditating, and one of the meditations, I received a message that said to heal my heart or my health challenge with color. And when I went on to the site, I found this interview that talked about healing with, sound and light. And I thought, okay, I think I'm supposed to watch this. And so I did watch it. I immediately resonated with Gail. I actually felt like I had met Gail before. We talked about it. It's like, I swear to God, you look so familiar. And I really resonated with the technology. And my initial thought was, I've got to schedule some sessions. I've got to get to an egg. So when I looked them up, the problem was there was absolutely none nearby. And I knew at that point that I was really in a debilitated state. I couldn't travel. There was no possible way that I could get to an egg. And then I knew that I would need to have several sessions, so that would involve some time. So I was really kind of in a quandary. I didn't know what to do. So I thought, well,
how some center owners just never come. They just call me up and say, I want an egg sight unseen. And I'm like, shouldn't you try it? And you said, no, I already know what this can do. And you're an amazing healer. So don't forget to talk about, well, you know, your background about healing and everything. You're just an amazing being.
Well, it does line up beautifully with my background because I am a Reiki master and I have certifications in a number of other healing modalities. So the whole modality really lines up with what I've done over 15 years. And when this kind of unfolded in such a natural way that I ended up buying the egg and I decided, well, I can either bring it home and put it in my garage or I can share it with other people. And obviously the latter won out and I'm so happy it did. So I love the egg and I've had great successes. I've been open for about a year and had remarkable successes with the clients that I've had. One of them, and I enjoy the ones that you can document a little bit. And my job prior to this was as a practice manager for an integrated medical clinic. And during that time frame, I'd met a gentleman, a young guy, who had a torn ACL in his knee. And he had not had any progress with helping this knee get well after the surgery. He had about a 10% range of motion, no matter that he'd had about a month worth of rehab at our clinic with an excellent physical therapist. And I suggested that he try a few sessions in the egg. And so we did the protocol that was recommended for this sort of injury in the egg. I suggested that he do 4 to 5 sessions, but continue with the rehab. He had been given a month to improve or they were going to do a second surgery. And this was, you know, a horrific idea to the young guy who didn't have health insurance and didn't want to go through another surgery. And over the course of those 5 sessions, roughly 1 month of time, he went from a 10% range of motion to a 90% range of motion on his knee and did not have to have a second surgery. And to this day, he's doing great.
That's so amazing. You know, my guy, Bill, mm-hmm. He had the knee surgery and a knee replacement, you know, and of course I tried to fix him in the egg, but I mean, his knee was bowed out. He looked like, I always tell him, like Fred Sanford on Red Fox. He had the parenthesis leg and he just had to have the surgery. And so I was able to get him into the egg. The inflammation went down. The physical therapist couldn't believe, I mean, he's 68 years old. And so they couldn't believe how fast he got to 90% range of motion. And when he saw his primary care physician 2 months after the surgery, she couldn't believe it was just 2 months because it looked like an old scar already.
Wow.
crazy. But of course, you know, some people just, he just said, well, I just did what the doctors told me.
Right. Right. Now, this guy actually has posted a review, so he recognized the role that the egg played in his recovery. Awesome. So that was wonderful. I also, you know, we do both in-person and long-distance sessions, and I have an example of a long-distance success story that's been phenomenal, and it's working with a five-year-old autistic child. He has some fantastic parents that are very open-minded, very receptive to new ideas, and they drove about 4 hours to the center for his first session, and this child, although he would speak isolated words, really never made sentences and didn't really communicate with his parents. And after his first session, the next morning, while they were still in town and they were staying at the hotel, they told me that he turned to them and said, "It's about time and space." Now, again, this is a five-year-old, and we kind of laugh about that because we all feel that he was talking about the egg. Well, this was pretty encouraging to them that just literally less than 24 hours later, he actually spoke a complete sentence. So they returned home, and we decided that we could try long distance sessions with him. Well, he's done so well. He averages a session maybe once every 2 weeks, and he has improved his ability to speak and communicate, his understanding. He speaks in complete sentences. He's able to address his teachers now by name and his peers by name. He plays better with the children. He interacts with them. He has a level of compassion and understanding that his mom said he never had before. He's not, she described it as not being in a bubble any longer, that he's actually interacting with the world around him. He's even expanding the type of foods that he eats. Now, I think as a parent, a lot of parents can identify with how hard it can be to get kids to eat. And he really would only eat about five foods. And now he's trying, he's becoming very adventurous and he's trying foods. She said he won't always eat them completely, but he is actually really trying a lot of different foods. So she's thrilled. And his progress reports from the school are totally different. He goes to a progressive school, but even so, they change. And she had to miss about, we went about 3 weeks without a session. And she said this kind of proved the egg factor to her, because his progress started to stall, that he was no longer continuing to grow at the rapid rate that he was. So we plugged in another session and he's doing beautifully again.
How many sessions has he done?
He's been coming for about 3 months. Okay. So my guess is, what would that be? 10?
Yeah. Because I tell people usually 3 to 10 sessions is going to reboot the system, because when you have something that's going on, sometimes one session isn't going to do it. You know, you want to buy a 10 pack, or you want to come consistently for, you know, in a short period of time. You know, once every 5 to 7 days is our integration period. So you want to get in there and you reboot the nervous system, and then you go somewhere, you level out here, you reboot it again. You might go here. Reboot it again until you're telling the system, this is normal. This is what the new normal is going to be, not that what they perceived as normal. Mm-hmm. So that's great. So that's about, yeah, that's perfect. And let's explain what remote sessions are too. So we actually take the client's photo and their name and birth date, and we are literally putting them in the egg. Energetically, they are in the egg. So that's the remote distance sessions for people that don't understand what that meant. So yeah, that's awesome.
And I've seen that proven time and time again, that there's actually something going on. Now with him, it's very easy to see because he's not aware that he's having a session. So the improvements we're seeing are independent of him. You know, with an adult, we might say, well, that person thought they were having a session, therefore, well, with this child, that's not the case. He doesn't know, but he's still improving, or she's seeing results, or he's more calm and he sleeps better that evening, and so on. Yeah. But we also, I don't know, Gail, if you want to share like the detoxing effects that we sometimes see.
Yeah, go ahead. What you shared yesterday with me about the smell.
Yeah. And that was actually confirmed. I checked in with her today to double check my facts, make sure that I was representing everything carefully and accurately. And with him, what I found, and I found this on a number of occasions, but this last time was very different. When I opened the egg, I smelt a very strong smell of dill pickles. So that I knew from prior experience is a detoxing effect. Now, again, he's, you know, 400 or 500 miles away, and yet the smell is appearing here in the egg. And I had mentioned it to her, but she'd never mentioned it to her husband. And she told me that this continued for about 2 to 3 days, and that her husband had actually said, you know, it's the strangest thing, but his poop actually smells like dill pickles.
Oh my God.
So I was like,
there's confirmation right there.
I said, did you tell him? What did she say? You know, I didn't tell him. And she said, and then after he told me, I didn't think of confirming it for him either. But I've seen this more than once, you know, where, so I'm absolutely convinced of its efficacy, and love remote sessions. It gives people who might not normally have the ability to come, someone who's older or more infirm, someone who does not want to come out in the middle of COVID-19, which is certainly understandable.
Absolutely.
It gives all these people a way to come and still, or, you know, come non-physically and still have a session in the egg.
Still experience the egg. And that's how distance and remote sessions were birthed, mm-hmm. no pun intended or pun intended.
Right.
It was during COVID, and a lot of my clients were elderly, and they said, you know what, Gail, I'm just afraid to come out. And I said, absolutely. And I thought, well, I'm an engineer, so I don't really, you know, I start overthinking everything. And I thought, distance sessions can't possibly work. That's ridiculous. Let's put someone's picture in the egg and they're going to heal, right? No. And so I said, well, let's just try it. And we tried it, and it's taken off. I mean, people love the distance sessions because they don't have to come out, or they're elderly and they're not very mobile, or it's children and you can't get them to sit still in the egg.
Right. And
so when you're doing, when a child is doing a session, you know, let them go play. Don't put them on in front of a TV or a computer or an iPad or something. Let them go play, let them draw, let them color. They don't have to sit still. But as adults, I tell adults, you know, lay in your bed, lay on the couch, but don't do anything stressful. You can garden, draw, paint, something.
Right.
So yeah, it's been amazing. And I've actually had myself on distance sessions when I was traveling. I've had one of the center owners, you know, put me in. I have my horse, so you can do it for pets as well. Because, you know, not every center owner has an egg just for pets like we do at the Life Center. And you don't want to put a pet in an egg that's a person's going to go in that could be allergic.
Right.
But you can put their picture in there. So I put my horse in all the time. I take her picture and, you know, put her into an egg. And she's just one of the calmest horses out at the barn that I board. And everybody says she's an amazing horse.
I've also done long distance sessions for pets and had a great story with an elderly dog who it brought the pain level down of this dog tremendously. And then I had occasion to do it for my own cat who ate a dead gecko and got a severe bacterial infection from this dead gecko and was a very sick cat. And so I was putting him in daily while he putting him I probably put him in more often than I might.
In a life or death situation, it's okay to go daily. Yeah.
It was pretty dire, and he recovered fully. And of course that was with the help of the veterinarian and some antibiotics as well. But I've had occasion to put pets in, and I, you know, but the concept is not as foreign to me, because when you're trained in Reiki, you're trained to do long distance sessions. So I had already done long distance sessions on clients in the past, and I had seen their response to the Reiki that I'd done. So for me, this was a great transition. It was something that I was already familiar with and already had faith in and had already seen, you know, work. So I love having the opportunity to do both types of sessions. They're fun. They each are unique in their own way.
Yeah.
Of course, anybody would love to be in the egg when they're surrounded by the beautiful music and colors, but
there's no comparison to being in the egg. I'm telling you, I still go for my sessions, and the egg seems to be getting more expansive, and it's almost like a self-organizing system. It keeps getting a higher level consciousness. And I was sharing with you yesterday, the one session I was doing recently, it almost looked like I could just lift up and just put my hand right through the egg, like it was transparent. It was such a beautiful experience. So yeah, there's nothing like being in the egg.
And one thing that I tell my clients, you know, that every aches session is unique. And there are times where I will go in and I will simply fall asleep and enjoy it. It's beautiful. It's relaxing. And then there are times like my last session, which was a couple of days ago, where I had vision after vision after vision, and each one was unique. And it was like, my goodness, there were so many that I, you know, when I got out, I couldn't remember them all to write them down, because I do like to document some of my experiences, because some of them are quite profound. Right. And I usually recommend people come in without expectations, because of course, some of their experiences have been transformative. And the next one might be as simple as just falling asleep. So right. I like to recommend that people just have an open mind and know that they're receiving what they need in the moment.
That's brilliant advice, because I do have people that come in with expectations of something they want. They don't, you don't always get what you want, but you get what you need.
Exactly.
We recently had an experience where a center owner called me and said that they had their first unhappy client. And I was like, okay, you know, some people are going to say nothing happened. Some people are going to say, you know, it was relaxing, but they don't understand. They're not tuned into their body. It was a young guy. And he said, excuse me, he said the egg gave him nightmares. Uh-huh. So I said, well, you know, there's probably a bunch of stuff this kid was holding on to. He needed to let go. Really? It could be the first time that he went into REM sleep and remembered his dreams. And I mean, there's so many factors that I explained to the center owner. Ask him if he had enough water. Ask him if, you know, he's ever dreamt before. Is this the first time he's dreaming and he's really going into a deep REM sleep? You know, there's traumas that can be released in the dream state. And after my sessions, I'd say 100% of the time, I have the craziest dreams, lucid dreams, smelling, tasting dreams. It's been mm-hmm. crazy.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah, I agree.
Well, thank you, Ms. Karen, so thank much you. For you know, your time and who you are and what you bring to the world. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Gail. And thanks for your wonderful creation.
Oh, it's for the world. I don't even know how I came up with this. It's just crazy. How can people find you?
So the website is harmonicegdallas.com, and simply log on and you'll see the contact information there. But if you'd like to reach me, you can reach me at 972-215-7763. That's the local number. And of course, there's a contact information on the website. But I'd love to hear from you. Love to hear from people.
Thank you so much, and have a great day, Karen.
Thank you. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.